Hello, everybody. Don't forget to share, invite. Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Blessings. Good afternoon, good evening to everybody.
Hallelujah.
Blessings to everybody. Blessings to everybody. Good evening, good afternoon to some, and good evening to others. Don't forget to share and invite others as we go forth in the conclusion of the teaching of rest. R-E-S-T. Yes, rest. Oh, yes. Yes. Praise the Lord to everybody.
Praise the Lord.
We send kisses and loves and hugs and all that good stuff all around the world. Yes. Yes. And I guarantee he's watching over to every state, every city and state that is represented on this Facebook Live. God bless you. Thank you for taking the time out. Amen. To stop by to hear the conclusion of the matter of what it is the Spirit of the Lord is saying to us, the church, regarding the word rest. So we're excited. Amen. As we go forth into finalizing the teaching. What we talked on last night is supernatural. I just wanted to come back on. I didn't want to have us out there hang time, you know. So we thank God, amen, that what God is doing for us, amen. For this is the will of God concerning our life. God is speaking to a lot of us. He's moving for a lot of us. And yet and still, some of us, glory to God, is really not coming into that rest like God is saying. And we need to realize there is a rest. It says it in a chapter 4, glory to God, of Hebrews. It lets us know there shall be a continuous rest. Anytime you see behind any type of word and it's a TH, that TH means continuously. So that means as God is speaking to us continuously, as God is promising us continuously, as God is saying what he's going to do for us continuously, we must keep entering into rest. Amen. And so to those that are writing it down, it's found in the book of Hebrews chapter 4. If you have not looked at the teaching prior to this, I say to you, go to the teaching prior to this and it will bring you up to speed. It'll bring you up to part of what we are talking about. Now, let me go ahead and forestate this to let everybody know. When I start talking about Sabbath, I'm not talking about the day like Saturday and Sunday. I'm not talking about that. I am talking about the Sabbath being in God, the Sabbath being in Christ, okay? So I'm not talking about the Sabbath that if you go to church on Saturday, amen, you keep going on Saturday. If you go to church on Sunday, amen, you keep going. That is not what I'm teaching about. I'm strictly teaching about the Sabbath and what God is saying concerning him. All right, and so let's get that up front. Amen. So if anybody come on, glory to God, and say the Sabbath and talking about Saturday and Sunday, Apostle Jackson is not talking about that. Saturday and Sunday, Apostle Jackson is not teaching about that, okay? If God told you to go on Saturday, then you go on Saturday. If God told you to go on Sunday, then you go on Sunday. So whatever God is telling you to do regarding that, that's what you do. But that's not what I'm talking about. That's not what I'm teaching about, amen? And so we bless the Lord for everybody, amen? It's found in the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 4. Watch what scripture says. Let us therefore fear lest a promise being left of us or us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. Now, because I have more time to teach it, glory to God, look at verse 1, chapter 4. It says, let us therefore fear, reverence, respect. Make sure we're doing this. Doing what? Lest a promise. So watch this, Sykes. That means God has promised the body of Christ. God has promised his sons and daughters some things. So it said, lest a promise being left us up, which means God has been speaking. Let me first state this. I'm not talking about other leaders. I'm talking about what God was giving me for the body of Christ. Are you hearing me? So the Bible said, lest a promise will be left of us. Mm-hmm. In other words, what God promised you or what God, glory to God, said he was going to give to you, it would not happen.
Uh-oh, come on now.
So therefore, we must make sure we are respecting God and what he is saying. We must reverence God and what he is saying. Why? Because if not, there will be a promise or promises, blessings that will leave us, not gone, but we will not be able to have it because there will be a rest that comes with your promise. Are you hearing me? And the Lord placed upon my spirit, he was weighing it heavy on me regarding it, because I'm seeing where God is speaking to all of us, promising us the very things that he promised, but yet and still, after we get the word, it's as if God never said nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, Apostle, would you pray with me? Well, we just got done praying. And we just got the word. And so we should be settling that. And watch this. We need to learn how to be like Jacob. When Jacob wrestled, he wrestled with the angel. So you got to learn how to wrestle with that word. Not the situation that is in front of you, but with that word. You can't let that word go. It is the word of God that is working in that circumstance. It is the word of God that is working in that situation. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? The Bible said in verse 1, let us therefore fear, lest a promise. Did you see that? Lest a promise being left us up. Entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. Come short of what? The rest.
Come on, yeah.
Did you hear me? Not the rest that's what's left over. Not the overflow. I'm not talking about that. The rest, resting in God. We have to, once we hear the word of God, once we know God has spoken to our season, and this is what God wants to do for us, and he wants to give us, we need to now enter into what? That rest. Are you hearing me? Because if not, beloved, you're not going to get that promise. If not, beloved, you're not going to get that blessing. I don't care how you shout. I don't care how you run around the church. I don't even care how you run around your house. You're not going to get that blessing except you come into the rest, not the overflow. The rest in God. A lot of us not resting in God of what he said. We think what the enemy is saying. Now watch this. Watch this. This is what the word means. A word. Word. It means to make an expression of. Okay? All right. Let me show you this. This is a what? A towel. Okay? Well, towel is what? A word. So the word towel must express itself. How does a towel, the word towel, express itself? It must show up as that word.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
That's how you know you have a what? A towel. But before you have the towel in manifested form, it is a what?
Word.
A word. So a word must express itself. It must manifest as itself. That's why the scripture said, and Jesus became flesh. Because Jesus was a word. And a word is invisible. But it became seeable.
Right.
Okay? That word became seeable. That you can see it in the natural. So, why did I say that? Because the enemy is shooting out words too. And the words he is shooting out is coming up, which is your situation. Is coming up, which is the problem. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And so we need to realize, hey Cole, come on now, not say. We need to realize that God is speaking a word and the enemy is speaking a word. But it seemed like, glory to God, that when the enemy speaks a word, his situation manifest quicker than what God is saying. Well, let me help you with something. God is not in a hurry. So he'll let him go first. Are you hearing me? You go ahead. Because when I come up and what I said to them manifests, the word manifests is going to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that they thought or even asked me. Are you hearing me? So what the enemy is doing, he's allowing those that are out there, he's dealing with people, dealing with, come on y'all, dealing with the atmosphere. Are you hearing me? And it is speaking, and it's speaking, watch this, corruptible words, and it still has to manifest.
Yes.
That's why we have to ask God to forgive us, because we spoke a lot of words, my God, from Zion when we was in the world. And so our life was framed by the words we spoke. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? I'm trying to give us understanding that when God speaks a word, it has to manifest. A word must express itself. That's why God said in Genesis chapter 1, let there be light. And light, the word light, manifested as light. And God said, as he looked at it, said, it is good. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
So, when God makes us a promise, he has given us a promise, and the promise is a word. And that word that he promised must express itself. Am
right.
I talking?
Yes.
So, if the word must express itself, the enemy word, he knows the power of a word.
Yes, he does.
The enemy knows the power of a word. Can I go ahead and help out three of us?
Help
All
us.
We got is a
help
word.
Us. Yes!
We are a word.
Yes, yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
We are a word. And so I need us to come into clarity, insight, and understanding of what God is saying. Because God has, glory to God, enlarged my territory, glory to God, with so many beloved, lovable, precious, glory to God, sisters and brothers in Christ that he's having me to minister to. And God is doing it. We're hearing the testimonies. But yet at the same time, we're hearing the testimonies that is supposed to build up our faith and to encourage us and say, God, you did it for my brother. You did it for my sister. You shall do what you said for me. Instead of that happening, we are still saying, okay, this situation that's coming, God ain't even working on it. Yes, he is.
Okay.
And then we're saying, can you keep praying? How long are we going to keep praying? Regarding it, we must pray without ceasing.
That's it.
Are you hearing me? But we are causing, what we're calling to pray for is to interrupt a believing what God told us regarding what's in front of us.
That's true.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, ma'am.
Let me say it like this. Let me say it biblically. Here it is. Moses was given the children of Israel the word of God that God is going to release. God is going to deliver. God is going to set free.
Right.
And do you not know all that Moses was saying, the children of Israel, they still wasn't believing? God gave them, my God from Zion, he gave them quail. He gave them water in the desert, in the dry place, and they still didn't believe God. Are you hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
And so here we are in 2017 with such great revelation that's coming from the East Coast, West Coast, South, North, and we still is not believing God or coming into that rest like we're supposed to. So you wondering why the promise ain't manifested? Mm-hmm. You wondering why the blessing ain't manifested? It's telling you right here in verse 1. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Because it says, let us therefore fear, respect, reverence. Reverence what God is saying. Respect what God is saying. Huh? L-E-S-T. Less a promise. Did you see that? Less a promise. What God promised us. He promised us a lot of things.
Yes, he did.
2017, baby, it is not just our year. It's our turn. It's our time. It's all that good stuff that is above all that. But we're not going to see it. And it's not because somebody missed. It is because we don't understand that we, my God, personally, individually, we must reverence, respect what God has said. Because other than that, the promise is not coming to pass. And some of us has been in this so long that we keep hollering, God, what's wrong? And God said, check your belief system out. Wait a minute. Come on now. Watch what he says. Go to verse 2. For unto us was the gospel preached. Okay? Unto us was the gospel preached. And if you go back and you see the teaching, you realize that we got saved from the preached. Some precious. I don't care if you was bypassing the tent revival and on your way, glory to God, to going out to a party. Or you got to bypass the church to go to do your thing when you was in the world. You still heard the preacher, which was preaching the gospel. And the gospel, if he was, he or she was saying at the time you was bypassing the tent revival or the church, be healed. That's the gospel. Be delivered. That's the gospel. Be saved. That's the gospel. Come on. Come out of darkness into the marvelous light. That's the gospel. Let Jesus be your Lord. That's the gospel. And guess what? You didn't stay in there to hear the opening, and you didn't stay in there to hear the closing. But some type of way, you heard the middle of it. It still was the gospel, and you kept on going. You went on and kept doing what you was doing, but you heard the gospel. And so the gospel is the word of God, which is good news, that somebody's life is going to be changed. And the word of God and the word is a seed. So regardless of the fact of we was going back to get high, regardless of the fact we was going to get drunk, come on somebody, and when you heard the word, it may not stop your drinking at that time. It may not stop you getting high. It may not stop you from getting out that bed that wasn't your husband or your wife. But guess what? That seed got in your spirit and you didn't even know that. And then when the time came, y'all ain't saying nothing. And then when the time came, when that word came into maturity, came into the fullness, because the scripture says in the fullness of time, that when sin came into the fullness, then God sent Jesus. So when the sin that we were doing came into the fullness of it, then the word that was sitting in your belly that you didn't even know you got, that was preached to you, that you didn't even know you was being preached to, has now came and said to you, it's time to give your life to Christ.
Come on, Leah! Okay. All right.
And so whatever circumstance that was in your life at that time got on your nerves. Well, yet once you was enjoying it, it now got on your nerve. Why? Because that sin came into the fullness.
Okay.
In the fullness of time, when sin was at its fullness, then God sent Jesus. Did you hear that? So when we came into the fullness of our sinful acts, But yet we heard the preached word. When it became full, then Jesus said, all right. Because let me tell you something. When my son was out there doing, my oldest son was out there doing everything he was doing up under the sun. How you doing, light? Be praying for him and still praying for my oldest son. Glory to God. The Lord came to me in a dream, and I know the term because I used to direct choirs, so I know the term of what this means. So in the dream, glory to God, the angel said to me, that means when you're singing a song, go back to the beginning. When you're singing a song, that part is over. Let's go back to the beginning. So what God was saying when he did this in the dream to me regarding my oldest son, he was letting me know that that's over for him. So it didn't matter what he was doing. God already told me that it was over, which means what he was doing came into the fullness. The act, because sin is an act.
That's it.
The act came into the fullness. It's over now. Not many days hence, come on somebody, your son gonna come in. I needed a greeter right there. That's what God is saying. Are you hearing me? So he says right here, for unto us was the gospel preached, as well as unto them. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith.
Come on,
so if we don't mix while the word is being delivered to us, being preached to us, if we don't mix faith with it, then it will not profit us nothing. So then what are you saying to me, Apostle? I can be sitting in church and hear that word for me, but yet I'm not mixing my faith with it. That's what the scripture says. So we need to make sure that when that word, what is back behind the pulpit or me sitting right here, glory to God, on a Facebook Live and preaching or teaching or prophesying the gospel, we must make sure while it's being delivered that the faith is being mixed. Just because you're saying that's my word and just because you're saying I hear don't mean you believe. We have to make sure. That's why, glory to God, the man said, I believe, but help my unbelief. How can you believe and then say, help my unbelief? You see that? Did you see that?
Yes.
So you and I must realize that I must mix my faith and make sure my faith, the faith of God, not the faith of Vanessa, the faith of God is being mixed with the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
That's some good stuff, because in Genesis chapter 1, it took the faith of God for God to create 6 days, and then on the seventh day, he rested from his work.
That's it.
That's what he worked. He worked his mouth, and that's the problem with a lot of us. We work in our mouth, but we're working it in the wrong way. Okay?
All
okay.
Right.
So the Bible says here, glory to God, though the word was being, the gospel was being preached, they was not mixing their faith with it, and it didn't profit them nothing. So they jumped around and shouted, threw 5 cloths over them, come on, picked them up, dragged them to their seat, they got in their car, went to work, come on somebody, and nothing never changed. Why? Because they sat in the house of God, they heard the word, and yes, that word was for me, but they forgot to turn on their faith system. I need to make sure, God, I believe, but help my unbelief. Are you hearing me? So here it is. Let's go to the word. Let's go to the word. Let's go to the word. Being mixed with faith in them that heard it. Are you hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
So don't tell me I'm off. It's in the scripture. For we which have believed do enter into rest. So we which have. Half is past tense.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So we which have believed, are you hearing me? That's all past tense words, into rest. So the circumstance of that situation is present, P-R-E-S-E-N-T, which is present right now. But you heard the word and you believe, you have believed, not H-A-L-F, but you H-A-V-E, have believed. Okay, so you entered into rest, but yet here is the situation and the circumstance which is in front of you. But instead of you staying in rest, you're coming out and you're trying to look at the situation in the flesh and then saying, God, where are you? And God said, hold on. Stay and rest in me, because I'm working behind the scenes. All things must come to a head. All things. If you got a bump on your right here, I got a little bump right here. I got a little pimple or something right there. You can't really see it. But guess what? At first I couldn't see it, but it was there until it came to a head. It became white. It came to a head, y'all. And guess what? I stopped trying to bust it. But watch this. It been there all the time. But I ain't started messing with it until I started seeing it come to a head. But I should leave it alone. Is that not right?
Right.
I should leave it alone because I could do what? Make it worse. But as long as I couldn't see it, as long as it wasn't affecting me, I wasn't bothering it. I stayed in rest.
Come on here.
But when I start seeing it, I start messing with it.
That's true.
Which is, if I don't mess with it, then it'll go ahead and finish doing what it needs to do, because now it's telling me it has come to a head, which means everything that's in it, everything that's in it that made that bump start acting up has come to a head. Now it must be what? Released. But since I'm messing with it, I know y'all can't see it. That's how small it is. But I can see it. I can look in the mirror and say, now where you come from? It wasn't where you come from. It been there. It just came to a head. Are you hearing me? And now that it's becoming to a head, and now I'm seeing it, it's bothering me. It's messing with me. And so I'm starting messing with it. But as long as I didn't see it, I wasn't messing with it. But it was still there. Are y'all getting that analogy? That situation was there all the time. But you wasn't messing with it. You was resting in God. You kept singing through the house, singing in your car. Are you hearing me? Quoting that word, God, you said, and I know you able to do it. But as soon as it came to a head, start messing with it. Start messing with it. And how did we mess with it? See, God, what's this, God? Oh, my God. We need to pray longer. We need to pray harder. Okay, did God hear us the first time? Didn't he tell Daniel? I heard you when you first prayed.
Yes.
I heard you when you first prayed about it. But what happened is the demonic forces, glory to God, in the atmosphere start messing. And so I had to send Archangel Michael to fight on your behalf. So that's why we stay and rest in God and bless God and praise God and keep giving God back that word in spite of, glory to God, them keep bringing, what you call it, notices. Still stay in rest. Then God is allowing, glory to God, that fight that Archangel is fighting is coming straight on through. The Bible said the angel said, Gabriel is going to come. Gabriel is going to come and tell you what it is you've been waiting on. But you need to realize that God heard you when you first prayed. And that's what the enemy wants to do. He wants to bring you and I out of rest. Because he realized if he bring us out of rest, we're going to get in trouble with God. And the promise that God made to us, God can't bring it to pass. He cannot manifest it. Because that promise is not coming. That promise is already there. It's just waiting on a due date. I need a greeter right there. I said that promise is not on the way. The promise is already there because it's a word. The promise is a word. The promise is a word. So it ain't on the way because you already got the word. And so that word got to do what? It got to manifest. And that word, which is that promise, has a due date that it must bloom.
Okay, you just said something right there.
Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I need to know if y'all listen to me. I need to know that you hear me.
You just said something right there. You just
Which
said
what
something
he
right
says.
There. Ooh, it's got a due date. Come
Watch
on
this.
Here.
Go to Genesis. I'm going to Genesis. Genesis chapter 2.
It's got a due date. It's already there.
It's already there. The promise is a word. It's already there, precious. It's already there. All it has to do is wait for its due date. When that due date come, my God from Zion, and can I go ahead and give about 5 smiles to somebody? It has to be already getting ready to come forth if the enemy just showed his head up and try to bring distraction or trying to bring detour. It must be about to manifest because he's too busy trying to work overtime. Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
For me to come out of rest. So it is about to manifest. But it cannot manifest if I don't what? Stay in rest. Come on, go to Genesis 2. Come on, that's all it is.
How about that?
Y'all know, you women out there, you know we was pregnant. They gave us a due date. It didn't matter. Yes, some babies came early, some babies came later. But however, it came on a day close to the due date. Okay? There's a due date that what God said is going to manifest, not come. Because when he said it, it came. It just now must what? Become flesh. Okay? Go to Genesis chapter 2. Watch Genesis chapter 2, beloved. Genesis chapter 2.
Wow.
And verse 2.
Wow.
And on the seventh day, God ended his work. Well, what work did he end? Because from the first day to the sixth day, what was he doing?
Working.
He was working by doing what? Speaking a word and saying, let there be. Are you hearing me? And when God said, let there be, it became in the realm of the spirit, and he said, it is good. Okay? But when the seventh day came, the Bible said he rested from his work. Are y'all hearing me?
Yes.
A lot of us have not rested from our work.
That's true.
We still talking, but we talking according to what's in front of us. When we should be talking what God said. God said, let there be light, and there was light. And then God said, and the light is good. So therefore, he, who is he? God was letting you know what he just said was good. So what are we doing? We're supposed to be working, and then after we work, we're supposed to what? Rest. Okay, it's right here. He said, and on the seventh day, God ended his work, which he had made, and he rested. Are you hearing me? Yes. On the seventh day, from all his work, which he had made. Are y'all hearing me?
Yes,
go to verse 3. And God blessed the seventh day. And God blessed the seventh day. The day you and I come into rest, that's the day we're blessed.
Okay.
The day we come into rest, we're blessed. The enemy know we're blessed as long as we stay in rest.
Got you.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
This is scripture.
Okay.
And he blessed the seventh day, which is the Sabbath. It's the Sabbath because he rested from talking. That's why I told you at the beginning, I'm not talking about you going to church on a Saturday or Sunday. I'm talking about the words that comes forth out of God's mouth and the words that come forth out of your mouth. And God rested on the seventh day, and he blessed the seventh day. Huh? He blessed the day of rest. He blessed the day of rest. So God can't bless the day of rest because you ain't came into it. Because you allowing the circumstance that's in front of you in the natural, because it was a word that came from the enemy and it still had to manifest. That's why you can't sit there and say that your kids ain't going to be nobody, because that word got to manifest. That's why you can't sit there, glory to God, in your hot steam, hot self, and tell your husband or tell your wife, I don't want you no more. It has to come to pass. Some of us sitting there, I'm broke. I ain't got no money. Listen, and that's why you ain't got none.
Talk about it.
The word has to express itself.
Talk about it.
It has to what? Manifest itself, because that's the way God created a word. The devil can't create nothing. He just follows suit, imitate, and then twerk it and twist it. Are you hearing me? A word must express itself. Are you hearing me? And our worlds were framed by the word of God. And our worlds, that means your world, my world, her world, his world, they world, were framed by the word of God. Are you hearing me? You're going to have to change your word. So that's why the enemy wants us to get frustrated and get us out of pocket, because he know, come on, talk. Come on, talk. Come on, say how you feel. Come on, say it. Come on, say it. That's what he be doing to us. Come on, say it. Because when you say it, you coming out of rest. And that promise that you believe in him for, you ain't going to get it. And that blessing you believe in him for, you ain't going to see it. Come on. This is what the enemy said. Come on, say it. Say how you really feel. Yeah, go on and say it. Then ask God to forgive you. Go ahead. That's why he said, be what? Quick to hear, slow to speak. What did he say in the book of Proverbs? Watch over your mouth. because you shall have. We always quote in that scripture. We quote it. Mm-hmm. We quote it. And I shall have whatsoever I say. You right.
Okay.
In your hot anger day, and your mouth just start flapping.
That's true.
Not just when you saying, and I'm the head and not the tail. Oh, but when your boss done got on your nerves, come on, have took you to the edge. And then you start saying, you know what? Today, I lose my holiness. And then you start flapping off at the mouth. And then after you get done, God, I'm sorry. Now, you got to understand what you said still must manifest. But thanks be to God, no weapon formed against us shall be able to prosper. He has to intervene and turn that thing around, that what we said in a hot, heated moment. Because words must express themselves. And the word became flesh. And the word became flesh. He created words to do that.
Yeah.
So the enemy knows that. So he takes a negative word and he begins to try to mess with us with stuff. Are you hearing me? And then when we begin to start talking crazy, he goes to God and says, did you hear what they said? Did you hear what they said? Okay. So then what day am I blessed? What time am I blessed? He blessed the seventh day. Yes, we know seven is completion. But what also does it mean? It means Sabbath to rest. And that's the time when you're blessed. Not this very situation that's dangling in front of you and want you to react to it. Don't react to it, because the way you and I going to react to it, I don't care if you hit somebody first, you still going to talk after you knock them out.
That's true.
You still gonna say something.
That's
you may true. Hit first and talk later.
That's true.
Are you hearing me? Words must express themselves. Words must come to pass. Whether you're in a heated moment or not, whether you high on the mountain talking about Jesus is Lord, words must express itself. Genesis 1 tells us that. He created it. Are you hearing me? But what I am saying right here and right now, and God blessed the seventh day. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
And sanctified it, because that in it, in what? In the seventh day. In the seventh day. He rested from all his work, which he, God, created. So then how did he rest from his work that he created? Because everything he created, he spoke it. He sanctified. And which sanctify me to separate, which mean I'm letting you know that it's that I'm done with that now. So now I'm resting. I already spoke it. It manifested in the realm of the spirit. Hello, lights.
Mm-hmm.
Come on. And then around about chapter 3, now you see it unfolding on the earth. And he said there was no man to till it yet, because Adam wasn't there yet to till it in the earth. I don't want to have to teach y'all that. Okay? But there is a rest that the body of Christ is not continuously coming into. We must continuously come into it. Why? Because God is continuously giving us promises and blessings. He's making promises and blessings with us. But we must continuously come into rest. All of us. Is anybody listening, or did everybody go home?
Okay.
My God, from Nikki, glory to God. We need to realize that. I thank God for whatever title you have, but I need to understand the word of God. I need to know what God is saying. Give me revelation. Come on, somebody. Watch this. I got to go to 1 Samuel. Let me take a little pause break right there. Go to 1 Samuel. Because I'm about done. First Samuel chapter 1. Because I got to remind us. We're taking this for granted.
That's true.
And we need
That's
not to true, be taking Pastor. The revelation of God for granted.
That's true.
Go to Revelation.
First Samuel.
I'm sorry. See, now I'm talking about Revelation. Hallelujah. First Samuel chapter 3. Y'all know the apostle word all day long. First Samuel chapter 3. And the child Samuel ministered unto the Lord before Eli.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see that?
Yeah.
He ministered unto the Lord before Eli. Eli was the one, wow, ministering to him, giving him the word of God. And before Eli, Samuel, yeah, was ministering before God.
Wow.
So while God is giving me the word to give to us, to you all, I should be seeing you ministering to the Lord before me, because the Lord has given me the word to you at this particular time. So I should be seeing you ministering to God like I'm ministering to you, giving God back his word. Okay?
Yes.
And the word of the Lord was precious. That's the problem with us. We just taking the word of God. Just, okay, happenstead, okay, get a word over here, get a word over here, get a word over here, get a word over here. You know, we done went to auction on the word. You know how they auction cars and houses out? We done got, now we done took the word of God, and now it's being auctioned out because we don't esteem it to be precious. We don't esteem the word of God to be valuable. We don't esteem the glory of God to be expensive. Baby, it costs for me to deliver a word. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
It costs, glory to God, for me to get an oil of the anointing and then begin to speak a word. It costs you too. You ain't going to just get it and my God from Zion. My God, it costs you something to get that word, because that word that you have gotten, glory to God, is valuable. And if you and I do not see it as being valuable, something is wrong. And we need to realize, it says, and the word of the Lord was precious in those days. There was no open vision. There was no open vision. That word open means to be scattered. Okay? That's what that word open means. It wasn't scattered. The word of God, revelation, vision mean revelation. It was rare. It was rare. But today, it's not rare. But today, it's not rare. Are you hearing me? But today is not rare. Those that are really in Christ, sold out to God, and they're standing up before the people of God, glory to God, and delivering the word of God, they have fresh revelation. It is being spread abroad, East Coast, West Coast, North and South, all around the world. So it's not rare. But now that we know it's not rare, guess what we doing? We playing with the word. And so therefore, we plan with it, we can't even enter into rest. Are you hearing me? But as long as that situation, that circumstance is in front of us, glory to God, keep hitting us in our face, then we saying, well, God, but you said.
Yeah, yeah.
But you did not come into the seventh day. You didn't come into the rest of God, where he blessed that day and sanctified it. Are you hearing me? You will make God mad. I'm telling you. God gets mad. Come on. Okay. The Bible says, and I'm about to close. The Bible says that the children of Israel, as all that God did for them, mm-hmm. only two people out of that whole tribe, all of that nation, went into the promise. And that was Joshua and Caleb. Because they wholeheartedly followed God. Are you hearing me? Mm-hmm. They rested in what God said. In yeah. spite of all what they had to face before they hit Canaan, they rested. But the other ones was murmuring and complaining. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And I was talking to my brother today as we was going to take care of some business. That here it is, the children of Israel, glory to God, the 12, out of the 12, my God from Zion, the 10 saw themselves as grasshoppers. Now, God didn't say that, but yet, instead of them seeing and saying what God was telling them to see and say, they came up with some grasshoppers. Are you hearing me? And they came back and said that and stirred the people up. And God got upset with them.
Yeah, yeah.
And only two went in.
Ataboko Shandi.
Only two went into the promise. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
So Hebrews chapter 4 verse 1 is giving us a warning.
Yep, yep.
And we're too busy looking at the situation in front of us. Well, apostle, it's her. Well, apostle, this, that, and the other. But then you're not resting in God, and you're not trusting God, and you're not believing God. And I'm not, watch this, I'm not no genie, and I'm not no sorcerer.
You don't come out here.
If you're not going to trust God, then you ain't getting the promise. If you're not going to believe God, then he's not going to give it to you, because it told you in the book of Hebrews chapter 4 and verse 1. If you don't fear him, respect him, reverence him, glory to God, there will be a promise, glory to God, that you have left.
Ooh.
Are you hearing me?
Okay.
Watch this. I'm going back to Hebrews chapter 4. I'm going back.
Okay.
He says...
Okay.
He says, let me go.
Wow.
Verse 5.
Wow.
And in this place again. That mean it happened before. So can I tell you, it's going to be again and again and again and again and again
mm-hmm.
and again
mm-hmm.
and again for us to come into this place. Because why? As long as we are in this world, we are not of it. But as long as we are in this world, trouble is in this world. And you don't have to go looking for it. It will come to find you. Jealousy is in this world. You don't have to go looking for it. It will come to find you. Is anybody listening?
Yes.
Evil and wickedness is in this world. Are you hearing me? You don't have to go looking for it. It will come to find you. Are you hearing me? So again, in this place, you're going to have to come back to this place. Once it manifests. Come on, once it manifests, once the promise manifests, once the blessing manifests, you're going to have to come back to this place again. You're going to have to come back to this place called rest in God again.
Okay.
So in other words, get yourself together, get your mind together to come back to visit this place again, 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 and again, and again, and again, and again. Okay?
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Come on.
Yes, ma'am.
And in this place again, if they shall enter into my rest, seeing therefore it remaineth, that some must enter therein. Some of us not entering in. And they to whom it was first preached enter not in because of unbelief. Did you see that? Those that first heard the word, the reason why they don't have the promise, the reason why they ain't see it, is because they didn't enter in because of unbelief.
Wow.
Well, Apostle, I did believe God. Lord, I believe.
Talk to me.
But help my unbelief.
That's me.
Lord, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
But help my unbelief. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Did you see it? This is why they didn't enter in. So you and I must make sure that we don't just say, oh, I believe God. But God, I believe, but help my unbelief. Because maybe there's something in me that I don't know nothing about that's not truly believing the wholeheartedness of you. Come on, Caleb. Come on, Joshua. Because you wholeheartedly, trust me, you're going in. You're going to experience the promised land. A whole nation. And God had to allow that nation that he brought out of Egypt to die off. And let the children, who didn't really know nothing about God, come on, come into a place that they didn't even till for. That they didn't even work for. Are you hearing me? But yet two of them, out of everybody, went in. And their response was, because we wholeheartedly trust God. We wholeheartedly follow God. No matter what the opposite that we saw. No matter what the opposite that we felt. No matter what the opposite of what we heard from what God said. We wholeheartedly followed him. And that's why Caleb walked up to Joshua one day. And said, remember what God promised me. He said, remember what God promised me. He told me back in some years ago that he was going to bless me because I wholeheartedly followed him. He said, and I'm looking at this mountain that's in front of me. Give me this mountain because I wholeheartedly followed him. I rested in him. Now, I can get the promise. Now the promise can manifest. And he said, I'm much stronger now than I was when I first got that word. I'm much wiser now than when I first got that word. Are you hearing me?
Yes, ma'am.
So give me this mountain because I rested in God and what he told me. So now give me my promise. So now manifest what he said. Did y'all hear that? Did y'all see that?
Uh-huh.
Huh? Uh-huh. Glory to God. So he says, there remaineth therefore a rest to the people of God. There remaineth. There remaineth a rest.
Wow.
There remaineth continuously. There remaineth continuously. Come on here. I'm checking to see something. Hold on. Hold on, everybody. I got to make sure this thing is still going.
Come on here.
There remaineth a rest.
You right?
Get your thing, minister, to see.
Yes, ma'am.
There remaineth a rest. That means that we need to enter into this rest. Are you hearing me? Verse 10. For he that is entered into his rest, he also cease from his own works. Well, then what is your own works? Your own works is what you're saying. It's what you've been speaking from what God was saying. Cease from speaking what God is saying. Are you hearing me? And now that you have entered in, now that you have rested, God said it's blessed. For he that is entered into his rest, he also has ceased from his own works, as God did from his. So a lot of us have not ceased. We have not stopped. Are you hearing me? We have not stopped. We haven't stopped. We are sitting here and we're talking about the very thing that God is saying, I'm going to deal with. When you speak that word goes into that situation. That word goes into that circumstance. And that word start working in it. Do you not know it's many factors that's dealing with, glory to God, your promise? It's many people, many situations, many negative words. All that word of God has to deal with that. Are you hearing me? Tear it all down and then manifest. And then cause, amen, that flower, that promise, that blessing to flourish or to bloom right in front of your face. Amen. Amen. That's some good stuff right there. God is a good God. So he says, let us labor. Let us labor, therefore, to enter into the rest, lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. So then what is God saying? Let us therefore labor. So you want to work? Labor it to enter into this rest. Labor to enter into this rest. Because if we don't labor to enter into this rest, the rest of God, or let me say the rest in God, not of God, but the rest in God, then we're not getting the promise. And a lot of us that I'm reading and I'm seeing that you're getting good word, you're getting fresh revelation, but your response is if God never said nothing concerning the thing. Do you think over 25-something years that it's been an easy road for me? It ain't an easy road for you and it's not an easy road for me. But I've made up in my mind that whatever God is speaking that he's going to bless me with, that he's going to give to me, that circumstance that's standing in front of me is not what God is saying. And so I can't agree with it. And I can't sit here and start talking negative. Yes, I heard you, Holy Ghost. That very thing should not get your time. Your time of conversation.
Got you. Got you.
Your time of conversation.
Got you.
You talking about it. Anybody got time to talk about the devil? Anybody got time to talk about what he's trying to do with whoever he's trying to do it with to get me out of my rest?
Got you.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, ma'am.
I trusted God when I had cancer. What is wrong? I trusted his word. He told me what to do. And when he told me what to do, Sykes, guess what? It was still there.
Uh-huh. Wow.
What he was telling me to do, it was still there.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
But the difference was, mm-hmm, I didn't get to stay in that long. Thank you, Jesus. Are you hearing me? Mm-hmm. Because over in Matthew, it says, except God shorten the days, we would have to stay in that frustrated bondage place for a long time.
Yeah.
That's why the children of Israel was never supposed to walk around a mountain for 40 years. It was only supposed to be for 3 days. That's why when God opened the mouth of the whale on the behalf of Jonah, he did a 3-day journey in one day. Because of what did God do? He changed the momentum. So a lot of stuff that we are in, we're still in it. It's because we have not entered into God's rest. And guess how you not enter in? And that is with unbelief. And you can say all day long, beloved, I believe.
Yeah.
Then why would Jesus put in the scriptures that this man said, I believe, help my unbelief? It is very important that we, as a body of Christ, in 2017, get ourselves together.
That's right.
Can I help you? The Bible said that the plowman, the reaper will overtake the plowman. That's speeding up the momentum. Now, let's think about that, precious one. If the reaper is going to overtake the plowman, and God is speeding up the momentum,
mm-hmm.
then how quick is another circumstance going to hit your house?
That's true.
How quick is another situation going to hit your house? But the problem is, you opening a door, and you telling them to come on in, and you trying to fix it, coffee, and you trying to, glory to God, amen, fix it, hors d'oeuvres, and all that. We're not understanding. There is another side to the coin. So while the reaper is overtaking the plowman, come on, that situation, come on, that negative situation is going to show up quick. But guess what? It's not supposed to stay, because everything's speeded up for you. And you and I know the ways of God. You're not getting anything without going through something. To know that he is God. That's what it's all about. To know that he is God. And that he's able to deliver you from cancer. And know that he is able to open up doors that they said they would never be open. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
You have to come in. Labor to enter in to this rest. And the only way you can is because of unbelief. And you and I will make God mad. Oh yes, with all our shouting and praising God, and guess what, loving on God. Talk to Saul. Saul rejected God. He rejected his word because he did not enter in rest. And he did what he wanted to do. He was fearing because of what the people was going to say, or what the people might do, or what this situation is trying to bring to me, or what this circumstance is trying to bring to me. And God sent Samuel, the prophet, right on back to Saul and say, tell Saul I stripped the kingdom from him. Come on, because he did not enter in to believe me. He had unbelief. He had doubt. Are you hearing me? You cannot be twixt and in between. You can't be lukewarm. Either be hot or cold. Because if not, God gonna spew us out of his mouth. Are you hearing me? And so I'm coming back, glory to God, to finish and to bring clarity and to bring insight and to bring understanding of what it means to rest in God. Because you can't rest in God and then have unbelief. And then keep saying, but I do believe God. Well, then how are you responding to a situation that hit your house? How are you responding to a phone call that you just got? How are you responding to a letter that you just got, and which is the opposite of what God said? How are you responding? And guess what? That was not supposed to stay in your life as long as it has been in your life. You are the one keeping it in there when you should be ignoring it. It had to show up because that was a sign to you that you got that word and that you have entered in the rest of God. Because the enemy is too busy trying to pull you out of rest. He's too busy trying to work to pull you out. It says labor. Labor. Watch this. Mm-hmm. Let us labor, therefore, to enter into that rest. Lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. You see that? And so this is why God had me to come on and to finish it, to conclude it, and bring clarity, and to bring understanding. Yes, precious, that situation is right there. And it's going to stay there as long as you keep on messing with it. Wow. It's going to stay there as long as I keep fooling with it. But if I leave it alone and ignore it, And even though when I go to the mirror, I can see it. As long as I ignore it, it already came to a head. So it has to do what? It's going to bust on its own. And guess what? Everything going to be back the same way it was. Right. But guess what I did? I ignored it.
Wow.
But as long as I keep, as long as it keep getting my attention, I'm getting ready to do something crazier to it. Yes. But when I don't give it no attention,
because
a lot of y'all giving y'all problems, your situation attention, and that's why I stand longer. Because you will not.
Got you.
Refuse. Refuse. And all this rich revelatory word that God has given you.
Wow.
You're not esteeming it to be valuable. You're not esteeming it to be expensive.
That's
it costs you something. You ain't on top of no cabinet. You are inside the cabinet with the key. And if somebody want to tamper with your life, they got to have the key to pull you out.
That's
come on.
Bullshit.
When you go look at real jewelry.
That's
real jewelry is not on top of the counter.
That's
the real jewelry is under. And the real expensive one is in the back. So hello. Hello. So the enemy trying to pull you out of the case and try to bring you from the back. And I'm not talking about you in back in the line, okay? I'm not talking about that.
Yes.
Trying to bring you out of the, being expensive to God. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
You're paying too much attention.
Wow.
To the present circumstance that you've been in for a long time, that it wasn't supposed to be there a long time.
That's true.
Jesus, our Lord and our Savior. He said, I only say what I heard the Father. I only do what I saw the Father doing. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
He said, now faith. So there's a faith that is now. And there is a faith that is later. So what faith do you want? Now faith. So we and you and I must enter in, labor to enter into that rest. That Sabbath. Are you hearing me? You either going to believe God and come into his rest, or you're going to keep paying attention to what's in front of you. And then you're going to stay in it a long time. And not only that, the Bible says it like this. The Lord sent his word to deliver us from that destruction. Why am I saying that? Because if we don't learn how to labor into that rest, he sent the word to deliver us from that destruction, which means that situation came to destroy us. That's what he's saying. That situation came to destroy us. So he sends the word to deliver us from destruction. So now what you gonna do? You gonna stay in this? You gonna keep paying attention to it? You gonna keep letting it have your time? Or you're going to speak the word like you've been speaking. You're going to give God the glory like you've been given. And then you're going to enter in. Labor to enter in. So that brings me to another light bulb that came on. Because if I go to work, if I go to work out, if I go to a gym, I'm going to work out. So I'm going to labor to work out to lose weight.
Right.
That means that I'm going to have to put what? Some time into this. Are you hearing me? So when one say that this is not a microwave age, what they're saying to us is it can be overnight because joy coming in the morning. How does that scripture go? With joy coming in the morning.
Do it for a night.
Huh? You can make what? Do it for a night.
But joy.
Coming in the morning. So how long are you supposed to stay in that? How long are you supposed to stay in that? Because joy cometh in the morning.
Not long.
So when I go to work out,
okay,
I'm going to put a timetable on it.
Okay.
And if I'm going to put a timetable on it, I'm going to have to labor to do what I need to do. Because at this particular time, I need to have toned up and lost that specific weight that I'm believing for. So I'm going to have to labor. Are you hearing me?
Uh-huh.
So this is not a microwave age.
Right.
But at the same token, when people are saying this is not a microwave age, they're not saying that you got to stay in this thing, my God, 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. Are you hearing me? Because if that be the case, then God is a liar. And God is not a liar. Because what was supposed to be 3 days turned to 40 years. And Jonah did a 3 day in 1 day.
That's true.
So now come on.
Come on here.
And then the prophet told the woman, leave because a great famine is going to come. But when it's over, 7 years, you're going to have to deal with this for 7 years. So can I tell the prophets and the prophetess and apostles something? We're going to have to start asking God. God, give us the timetable of this situation for them.
Oh, that was good.
Give us the timetable.
That was good.
Of the situation for them.
Yes.
Because when that time is up, and Jesus got my back, because
yes.
when Satan came to try Jesus
yes.
in all 3-point area of his life, that season was up. And when that season was up, he had to leave him. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
So all the prophets and the prophetess and the apostles, and we walk in the apostolic, and we walk, glory to God, in prophecy. We need to start asking God, God, give us a timetable of how long that this person has to stay in this trouble, in this tribulation, in this pain, in this. The Bible said that one lady was in a situation for what? 12 long years. That's because when she walked up to Jesus, that 12 years is over. You're not going to have a 13. Are you hearing me? Then there was not another one, glory to God, and began to tell us how long they was in it. They wasn't in it that long because Jesus was on scene. They were in it that long because you have to understand there was a timetable to everything. And so now God is saying, ask me the timetable. How long a person had to stay, glory to God, in that bondage? How long? Because God told him in the book of Genesis, my God from Zion, that my God, Joseph told his brethren. He said, listen, I'm getting ready to go on to be with the Lord. But guess what? God's going to come to visit y'all. When God come to visit y'all, hello, lights, take my bones with y'all. He's going to release y'all out of bondage. Are you hearing me? Y'all coming out of this. Okay, God, so then what is the timetable? How long am I supposed to stay in this? Because if you allow me to get in this, then you got a timetable of how long I'm supposed to stay in this. So then, God, how long is that person's marriage is supposed to be jacked up like this?
Wow.
How long is that child supposed to be out there on the streets on drugs? How long, glory to God, is that child that's in prison, glory to God, my God, wrongly? How long are they supposed to stay in there? God, I need you to give me the timetable of this.
That's it. That's it.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Because when the prophet gave that woman that timetable, 7 years. Do you not know she was following that calendar?
Yes.
And when 7 years up, let's go, family. And we going back to get our stuff. So we have to labor to enter into this rest. Are you hearing me? And a lot of us that I'm seeing, glory to God, as God is blessing us and giving us this fresh revelation word concerning our situation, we're acting like God ain't even speaking. We're being tore down from the floor up over what's in front of us. We're giving so much attention to that we're doubting God.
That's true.
Are you hearing me?
That's
and
true.
I'm telling you now, God gets upset about that. Are you hearing me? It is God's good pleasure to give us the kingdom. It is God that wants to give us promises and blessings. But precious, you and I must labor to enter into this rest. So if you're going to labor to enter in, that means it's a force that's going to try to keep you from entering in. So labor to enter in. Because when you first go to the gym, and then I'm done. When you first go to the gym, boy, you going on. You picking up weights. You running on that treadmill. You doing everything.
Yep.
Until you take your bath and get up the next morning. Woo! You can barely move. But guess what? What you feeling should not deter you, because I'm laboring to tone up and I'm laboring to lose this weight. So regardless of how I'm feeling, I gotta go back. I gotta push beyond this pain and go back and do it again. So we got to labor to enter into that rest. When God got done speaking the heavens and the earth into existence, from the first day to the sixth day, on the seventh, the Sabbath, he rested. He blessed the seventh day and separated, which is sanctified. Are you hearing me? And then it began to manifest on the earth. We saw the trees, and I still see them today. I see the sky,
and we still see
I see the birds.
Yes.
I see the cows. And if I go to the zoo, I see the giraffe. If I turn on the TV and go to the Animal Kingdom channel, I see it all.
Yeah.
And I see these old crazy nets. Somebody need to pray, because I tell you, I'm so sick and tired of these little nets. They're everywhere. Are you hearing me? Every creeping little thing, every creature. And guess what? Everywhere I look, I see human beings.
Yo,
so what he spoke, which is what he made a promise. And a promise is also a pledge and a vow. God is telling us, you skating on thin ice. You better tell them. Tell them they skating on thin ice. Because I gave them a word. And they will not labor to enter into this rest. And we running all over the place.
Yep.
And we trying to get a fixed word. As long as I feel good with that, okay, that's the word right there. No, the word you got before. But when I got that word, all hell broke loose, which means it came to a head.
Oh, gotcha.
It came to a head. That word got in that situation.
That word.
And it was coming to a head, but you didn't know how to handle it.
Yes.
You didn't know what you were seeing. You didn't know what you were feeling. Buckle your seatbelt. You didn't know what you was hearing. And so, let me run over here. Let me run over there. And I'm not telling you not to go and get other words, but you need to understand, why are you still trying to get another word on this situation when you already got the word, and that word that you already got is causing the situation to come to a head now?
Okay?
Come on.
Yes.
So labor into his rest, because if not, what do you say? Seeing therefore it remained that some must enter therein, and they too whom it was first preached enter not in because of unbelief. God is not playing. He's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. God has given us fresh revelations, and we need to stop playing. And we need to take God for real at his word, and we need to ask God to help our unbelief, and we need to labor to enter in his rest. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And stop trying to make people gods. People ain't God. It's only one God. It's only one faith. And it's only one baptism. And if you're not going to trust the true and living God, then you're going to trust your circumstance to be your God. Because whatever you trust is your God. So if you trust God like you say you trust God, you already know automatically that word have just caused the enemy, come on, to start stirring in that situation that God said he was going to bless you out of. That's how you know. But don't mess with it. Don't pay no attention to it. All right? So this is that. This is what I'm talking about. Laboring into God's rest. Okay, beloved, I thank you for your time. I thank you for your spiritual ears. I thank you for your spiritual mind to hear what God is saying to us, the church. He made us a lot of promises. He made us that he was going to give us blessings. And this is how much he don't just want to be saying it, but he want to give it to us. Are you hearing me? But he want us to trust him as who he is to us. He is my God. He is my Lord. He is my Savior. He is my father and my mother, because they both went on to be with the Lord. Are you hearing me? So I trust God. I'm taking him at his word. And God, help my unbelief, because I must enter into your rest. This is supernatural, the conclusion of the matter of the word rest. So I pray, beloved, that I have spoken, glory to God, something, have taught you something that will bring clarity, insight, and understanding to your life, to let you know the promise of the Lord is yea and amen. What he promised that he was going to bless you with, he will give it to you up under situations, up under, you got to understand, it's up under condition, and it is that you enter into his rest. Amen. I love everybody. May the blessings of the Lord make you rich and add no sorrow. Until, what's today? Thursday. Until, if the Lord tarry, until next Wednesday. Amen. Pray with me. Pray for me. Glory to God. Because we are getting ready to go. And we're getting ready to do the will of the Lord. We're getting ready to teach. Amen. We get ready to go to LA, and we have an assignment. And so, We have an assignment that we're coming up to, which is this Saturday. And I pray that you all will pray for us. We are headed to Houston, Texas. And surely we're headed to Arlington. Check out the flyer on my wall. If you're anywhere in the vicinity or whereabouts around about Houston, meet me there Friday, April the 21st. If you are somewhere in the vicinity of Arlington, meet me there April the 22nd. God is enlarging our territory. And guess what? We are entering in to his rest. Until next time, beloved, you go with God. I love you.